Reality.
Yellow.
See.
Blue.
Imagine.
Yellow.
Fear.
Blue.
Want.
Yellow.
Meeting. Seriously.
Rove Live, brought to you by the small four-wheel drive that's built to four-wheel drive. Mitsubishi Pajero EO.
Rove Live is classified M and is recommended for viewing by mature audiences. It may contain some coarse language and adult themes.
Stacks on.
Stacks on. I drive everyone nuts.
He's so cute.
Yeah, we'll bring this baby home.
Oh, I'm heaps insatiable.
Guess who lost?
Great.
When the applause goes too long, I get suspicious. They can't like me that much, surely. Welcome to Rove Live. I have to start with this. It's been quite an amazing week. I don't know if anyone or any of you caught this story, but last week, what they're saying may be the first time a Muppet has ever spoken at the US Congressional Committee happened when Rove Live favourite Elmo spoke in Washington. Elmo. Now, what I love about this is the fact that they're saying it may be the first time a Muppet has spoken. Like, maybe one snuck in once and they didn't quite catch him. Except maybe one crafty-eyed senator who leant forward to the person next to him going, since when has the national spokesperson for nuclear fission been 8 foot tall with yellow feathers and a beak?
Me don't know. Cookie, nom nom nom.
I'm so glad you laughed at that, because I wasn't quite sure how it would go. Because on paper it just says, cookie, arum, yum, num, 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 num. And trust me, with a funny voice, it'll work. Now, for those of you who didn't see it, here's some footage of Elmo making his speech. Get your Oz ready now. Have a look. There he is. With his little... Oh, look at him with his little suit on. And it's like the tiniest suit I've ever seen. That was actually the hardest thing for Elmo to make the speech was finding a suit that small. But he did promise me he'd return it in time for the Logie, so that was much appreciated. Now, this is one of those things I think it might end up being one of those only in America sort of things. Like, I can't see, like, the Australian government listening to a puppet talk, other than John Howard, of course, but which I think is the reason why the Prime Minister wouldn't invite Elmo to come and talk here, because I think everyone would get the two of them confused. But I think it is going to take off. Puppets in Parliament, in fact, they are implementing plans for it to happen here, although John Howard did get a little confused and ended up inviting puppetry of the penis, and it really just got ugly for everybody. Are you ready for a fine show, ladies and gentlemen? Oh, yeah, it's a pretty good one tonight here. Joining us live in the studio, Hollywood heartthrob Guy Pearce. My favourite little Colombian singer, Shakira. Bold and the Beautiful star, Ronn also here. The next of the Big Brother evictees, Katrina Miani. And comedian Dave Williams as well. It's a ripper. Of course, Logie's night happened Sunday. We all had a good time, and here to tell us all about it, it's the two and only Peter Hellyer and Corinne Grant.
Hello. How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Now, first off, must say thank you to everybody who voted us most popular light entertainment program. Very much appreciated. We got a little shiny man.
Yeah, look at that. That's a real Logie right there.
Yes, thank you to the one person. Brenda's happy with that. That's good.
I've actually been sleeping with a Logie for the last few nights, and some advice, don't sleep with a Logie if you're naked. And if you do not roll over. Do not.
Especially if it's cold, because it'll stick to you.
Oh, should I touch that?
Probably not. Did we all have fun? Did you guys have fun?
Well, no, I did. But then when I got to the after party, I left and I was ahead of all of you guys and I waited for you and I couldn't find you and I was left standing around going,
But that was intentional. Like, it was hard. How fast were we running?
Because you're quick. Like, you almost caught up at one point.
We were getting worried. I got stuck talking to the Australian Survivor kids. And I must say, I like those kids a lot better when you can actually change the channel. I really.
You want to devote them out of the park.
Exactly. But it was a great time, great party. One thing I was upset with the Logie ceremony, you know when they have the honour roll of those who have lost over the last year? No Madge Ramsay.
Yeah,
Harold was very upset at the after party.
I saw him blubbering into his wine. He could have just been making that noise. Really hard to tell.
Very upset.
Now, obviously, Pete and I, we had good fun.
Yeah, you had fun.
Yeah. We caught up with Burjo. We've got lots of people.
Burjo, we were doing catchphrases. It was great.
It was good. But actually, we did. I mean, obviously, you do sometimes have a little bit too much to drink when you're out celebrating television's night of nights, and you know things have gone horribly wrong. You know you've had too much to drink when, as Pete and I found out, you've had too much to drink. We end up getting told off by Alf Stewart from Home and Away. Have a look at this. That's. He was fired up. Oh,
I thought flaming mongrels was a bit rough.
Yeah. At one point, I really thought he was going to put his foot right up our kiber, but I thought he really meant it. I really did.
What did you do? Did you mention Al, sir?
No. I meant it was Bobby. I mentioned Bobby. Yeah. Damn it! I don't think we'll ever be able to go back to the diner. That's
no,
what I'm
we
worried.
Can't. I think next time I try to use that hamburger phone, I'm going to have to pay. I'm going to get that for free. Now, Pete, having escaped Corinne. We thought because you'd had so much to drink, we thought we'd give you a camera.
Yes, thank you. Feed me with an IV drip of alcohol and give me a camera and a microphone.
But you did go out and chat at the after party?
I caught up with some friends and some people I've never met before. And I think it shows.
Have a look.
Here we are with Ronn, Ridge, Master. Did you enjoy your first Logies?
Oh, absolutely. It was a blast. I didn't know how rude I was actually going to get with Wendy, but... I think we had some fun.
Well, I think humping somebody's leg is, you know, considered reasonably rude.
But I would really like to apologise to the people of Australia, but he started it.
I thought it was a highlight, personally.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I think, but you're a filthy, you know. You're a sick, sick puppy, you know.
She's got me there.
And where do you put your gold logies?
Anybody want a pash? I say Big Kev roaming around.
No, it's not going to happen, man.
Naomi Robson will not pash Big Kev. There you go.
Say that.
Oh, no, sorry, she didn't say that. She might pass Big Kev. Who knows?
They're on top of the stereo.
I'm not convinced.
It's a very nice stereo.
Are you in a Star Wars film like every other Australian actor at the moment? I would love to see you in Star Wars.
You reckon?
Oh, you'd be great. You'd be great. Jabba the Hutt and Flathead Fisher.
Not convinced.
Where would you like me to put them?
I really enjoyed it, and I'm really glad that the show won. It's fantastic, because I love your show.
My show, yeah, of course. My show, hit live every Tuesday night. Check it out. Is the McAuliffe program coming back next year?
No, that's it. It's finished.
It is finished?
Yeah.
That's ABC for you. You're too successful.
That's right. Well.
And what was it like? Your brother presented you the award. Did you feel like getting up there and like just giving him a Chinese burn?
Oh, well, I did whack him once or twice when we were kids.
That bloke on road.
Speak to Krista Bendy.
Yeah,
well, I reckon people watching this want to look at him.
Of course they do. I notice you always think you top off more than Ben. Does Ben have man boobs?
I went to the toilet 3 times and I looked over my shoulder 3 times and who was right behind me? This man.
Yeah, I was actually starting to sniff cocaine so you wouldn't get suspicious about my bladder. Here we are, the Logies finishing up, of course. Thanks to everyone who won.
Hey, Pete.
We've run out of time. Back to you in the studio. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot.
The only one who was a band.
So there you go. Thank you very much for that, Pete. And thank you, Corinne, as well. Yeah. And once again, thank you to everyone who did vote for us. It is very much appreciated. We'll be back with more Rove Live when we return. Guy Pearce, Shakira, Katrina Miani, but next, Ronn Moss.
Dream.
could be completely lost in this dream
forever. Know how to protect themselves. Carefree, simply no better protection.
Stop me, Carol. Remember everybody? Who wears the pants? Yes, that goes. Oh, no. Is this your first time?
Yes.
Lovely little doggy. Enjoy the rest of the group, please.
Oh, Jimmy boy.
Fly me to the moon, let me play among the stars, and let me see what spring is like on a Jupiter and Mars.
Get a powerful desktop PC without the desk. The Intel Pentium 4 Processor M, designed for notebooks.
The Chill Out Annual from Ministry of Sound.
There we go. 10 pieces of chicken, chips, potato and gravy, coleslaw and a bottle of Pepsi.
Yeah, but where are Mum's chocolates?
Make Mum's Day with a Mum's Feast from KFC.
How you doing out there,
Springfield?
Look out, world. He's Homer Simpson. Ooh. Rock God.
Yeah. The Music World's latest smash. The Simpsons, 7:30 Wednesday. Then at 8 on Just Shoot Me.
Smashing, Governor, look who's back from blighting.
Enjoy an all-new episode.
God, I love England. It's got everything. The tea and crumpets, the fish and chips, the spotted dick.
All-new Just Shoot Me, following The Simpsons Wednesday.
Welcome back to Rove Live. What a show we have for you. Guy Pearce, Shakira, Ronn Moss, a whole lot more. Now, one thing I would like to mention, there was a bit, it wasn't just Logies on Sunday, my friends. There was another big event held on Sunday. It was the state qualifiers of the musical team Dressage, a local pony riding club. And we sponsored a team from the Macclesfield Pony Club in Victoria, and they competed on Sunday. Here's some footage of them in action. The girls, Louise, Amanda, Stephanie and Michelle, they had Rove Live t-shirts on, Rove Live horse blankets, and rode to our theme music, which is, look at that. Oh, careful. Oh, that's dangerous. Don't try that at home. These are trained young girls on horses. very happy to announce that they got 59 out of 100 points, which put them in 7th place. Unfortunately, that was out of 8 teams. So, yes. Thank you to the girls. Actually, just want to... Did anyone else notice? Have another look in the final shot. When they went back together, they've gone incorrectly, and because they had the R-O-V-E, they've gone in reverse, and it's evil. It's just as well they weren't wearing the Rove Live, the full Rove Live. Otherwise, it would have come out as Evil Ivor. My evil twin brother. He has a goatee. That's how you can tell us apart. As all evil brothers do. Where am I? What the? Just sometimes it's best not to even try to think of a segue. Just go with it. The first what the this week comes from Jay Winter from the entire state of New South Wales. A little plastic toy of a dinosaur. The largest creatures
on Earth ever to roam the world. And of course, as history has dictated, dinosaurs, despite being very large, had very small brains. But according to this plastic dinosaur, they also had other large parts. No wonder they all died out. When an asteroid is crashing to Earth, you can't run away when you're trying to drag this. Must run. Next is from Peter Roth from North Fremantle in Western Australia. It's coffee from overseas. Already you know it's a guaranteed winner, my friends. This one has the rather creative title, I've never seen coffee that can guarantee that it will ease your bosoms. Mmm, what the? Yes, for those times your boobs are really stressed out. A couple of cups of this and you'll be fine. Although I can't take it because I find when I have it, my breasts are just up all night. I just can't get them to sleep. Lisa Madsen from Sutherland in New South Wales has sent us the next what the. It's from their local community newspaper advertising a new tactile pathway for the vision impaired. Basically, have a look at it. The way it works, they've got bumps on the path so blind people can quite happily feel it with their feet and walk around. So the blind person just goes la 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 la, follow the bumps on the path unless they find something like, oh! Okay, don't panic. Like, the blind people haven't been bumping into it because their dogs are hitting it first, so they're all okay. Final one is from Lisa Wright from North Parramatta in New South Wales. You've actually gotten this from half the state of New South Wales, so you can please stop sending it in. But Lisa was one of the people who did an ad for an injury compensation service that's asking the question, have you ever been injured in a pubic place? If you ever want to send it to us, get at this address. It's what the PO Box 382, Richmond, Victoria 31211. All right, my first guest this evening is watched by over 350 million fans around the world as they watch the trials and tribulations of his everyday life. You know, it's the usual thing. Guy marries his stepmother, they divorce, she marries his brother, he marries a new woman who's then kidnapped by a crazed lady and held for hostage with the daughter before then the crazed woman goes off to try to kill his mother. It's the usual thing. We've seen it 1,000 times. So if playing Ridge in Bold and the Beautiful didn't tire him out enough with those bizarre storylines, he also finds the time to release a CD. This one is I'm Your Man. He is the man. Welcome him now, the Bold and the Beautiful Ronn Moss. How do you do?
Give me that mic.
Please, have a seat.
No, you have a seat.
No, I can't. You're the guest.
Yours isn't higher than mine. What's the thing?
It should be. I'm tiny. That's a fine buckle, my friend.
Thank you.
That's amazing. Yeah. Blinding.
I just had a beer backstage, so I'm feeling kind of like
right.
Buckle man.
Are you enjoying Australia? This is your first time here?
Not really. Lovely country you have. I wish I could have seen it.
Yes, now, you were mentioning before the show, we're having a brief chat, and you're saying you haven't had a chance to see anything at all.
I haven't seen a bloody thing. I've gone from a TV show to a radio show to a radio show to a TV show to a humping somebody's leg.
Yes.
To, and I haven't seen a damn thing. Anyway, I'm looking forward to coming back to actually see your country.
Now, mentioning humping the leg, that was Wendy Harmer at the Logies on Sunday night.
Yeah, I brought this tonight.
Oh, here we go.
Just in case we needed it for
you.
Oh,
okay, yes. Because you could get excited.
I could. You never know what will happen now.
Did you enjoy Sunday night?
Yeah, I did.
Did you go out? I mean, what did you do after? Did you have to escape from being mobbed?
You guys drink too much.
That's what we do.
And you were a very bad influence on moi. I cut myself off early in the evening, and then we had to go to the parties afterwards.
Yeah.
I saw you there, too.
Oh, yeah.
And they started serving the shots. And you got to do it.
It's pressure. It's rich, man.
I didn't feel anything until the fifth one. I thought I'm doing fine. And then with the combination of the jet lag, I was so wasted the next morning I couldn't believe it.
Did you try to take some coffee or something to wake you up?
Yeah, but it doesn't help. All it does is accentuate the lag that's happening. I felt like that slow motion thing. It's like you said, when your mind's going fast, but your body just won't keep up.
Yeah, because if you're so tired, your brain is actually dead.
Yeah.
And you can't even string a sentence together, and you think, oh, no, coffee, that'll fix it.
Yeah.
And all it does is just make you speak faster, but you still can't put sentences together. So, and how is the bold and the beautiful? Because we see you as Ridge. There are some extraordinary storylines happening in that show, would you say?
No, they're very realistic. Come on. We don't do anything accentuated at all. There's no drama, really. It's amazing. I've got stuff where I've had to impregnate a girl because my wife said it was okay, but I didn't actually talk to her to get the okay. This girl said, your wife said it was okay. So I went, oh, all right. Well,
sounds good to me.
Sounds good to me. My wife sent me an email and said, it's okay, so let's do it.
That'd hold up in court. So what's the weirdest storyline you've ever been offered or have done on the show?
I did a storyline about impregnating.
I must admit, I thought maybe there's a stranger one than that. Who can say?
There is, actually, but I can't get into it.
Okay. I would like to show a bit of footage of you in action, if I may. Here it is.
Just tell me it's not the coma thing again.
No, it's not the coma thing. That was great.
Three out of the four scenes they show, I'm like this.
But is that easy when they give you a script saying you're going to be in a coma?
You love it. I love it. 20 pages of dialogue a day, and I come in and go, I'm in a coma. Fantastic.
I'm going to sleep. Wearing off the jet
what
lag.
What could be better?
But here is Ridge in Bold and the Beautiful in action.
I'm a man. You're a woman. A naked woman. What of it?
I think it's more than that. And you know it.
I don't know. It just makes me. It gives me that warm feeling.
It's moving. It's moving stuff.
Yeah.
Now, I mean this with all due respect. Do you sometimes? Is it hard not to laugh when you're doing things like that? Like, you know, I know it's dramatic, but sometimes it's the drama is so heightened.
We actually have to do it enough where we are not laughing when we actually do the take. We'll just, yeah, you know, got to get it out of your system. So you just, you know, say the lines over and over, and we bust each other up, and then you got to try to do one serious take. And do that look at the end.
Now, is that what...
That smell bad, you know, look, like something smells bad. You do this. And you got to hold it until they fade out.
I that's called food for thought in the industry. Like, you're just thinking, it's like, oh.
Smells bad.
Oh, that's too much, I'm going too far. But now, you've also got a music career as well. In the 70s, you had Baby Come Back, the big hit, and you've got the new CD, I'm Your Man, out now as well.
I keep saying is a total tongue-in-cheek title. Please take it that way.
Now, we have a radio show, and on that radio show, we have a segment called Musical Microscope, where we look at lyrics of certain songs. Mm-hmm. And I have had a look at I'm Your Man. I had a listen. I'd just like to read out some of the lyrics here. If you want someone to light your candle, more heat than you can handle, I'm your man. If you want some fishes in your ocean, some magic in your potion, I'm your man. This is my favourite. If you want some rhythm in your tango, some fun in your fandango. Is the music a first love, or was it the acting that came first?
No, absolutely. The acting's been kind of a sideline to a little jog in my life from the music, because I started out so early in rock and roll. I was always a rock and roller.
And I believe you're actually going to be coming back with a tour to properly promote the album.
Yeah, we'll do July, 1st of July, the first 3 weeks of July, we'll come back to here. Where are we?
We're in
Los Angeles, Melbourne, Sydney, Adelaide, Perth, and everywhere in between.
So is that just you? Because you're not so much with the band.
I'm going to bring actually half a band, and we'll get half the band here. But the two guys that'll come with me are two guys from Little River Band.
Oh, really?
Peter Beckett and Tony Sciuto are going to come back. And
Now, are they okay? Because when Baby Came Back first was released in the 70s, I think it actually prevented the Little River Band from making it to number one
at
the time.
They did.
Are they bitter about that? Are they happy? Are they going to throw? Are they not going to play properly maybe during the tour?
They're going to screw it up. Well, actually, one of them wrote Baby Come Back, so...
Oh, that's okay then.
He's not going to screw it up.
All right. Now, just before you go, I'm an aspiring thespian.
Really?
And I was just wondering if you'd help me out. I've got a little script here to take me through. If you wouldn't mind doing a little Bold and the Beautiful style soap opera scene with me.
Did you write this?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So, if you need some stuff to come up with or
so
something.
So you're like an aspiring writer too?
Yeah. You know,
you want to do it?
Whatever you think, you know. Now, I thought you could play the part of Ridge. And I'll play the part of your love interest, Ravina, which is also a tasteful berry fruit drink, just out of interest. Okay, if we can get some, can we get some, like, bold
organ music?
Mood lighting would be good. And that sort of, you had that smoky effect? I think we've got some smoky effect.
We've
got
to have some smoke.
There we go, yes, the nice foggy effect. And a bit of atmospheric music as well, Maestro, if we could. And I believe you've got the first line.
Bossy bastard, isn't he? Rovina, I need to talk to you.
It's too late for words, Ridge.
It's not too late.
Isn't it? Can words heal a broken heart, or mend a broken spirit, or fix a leaky tap?
There hasn't been a single moment, a single night where I haven't thought of you, or I haven't thought of calling you. I'm telling you how much I...
How much what?
How much I love you. I think I've loved you even before I met you.
Okay. It's just getting weird now.
Keep going.
Keep going. Sorry, yes, this. This one over the page, I think.
Okay. I do love you, Rovina. Rovina?
Yes, that's it.
If I could give you my eyes, if you could see through my eyes so I can look into my heart. Let me try that again.
Okay.
If I could, I would give you my eyes so you can look into my heart and see how much I love you.
Hey, sounds a bit gooey. How about you just kiss me instead?
But what before we do?
I never thought you'd ask.
Before we kiss, I need to tell you something, Rich.
What is it, my precious little love monkey?
I'm a man.
What the? Thank you very much. We'll be back with Guy Pearce, Katrina from Big Brother, Dave Williams, and Shakira.
Is a 10 News Update.
After Rove, it's 10 News, and tonight, Australia's health insurance crisis. Doctors and surgeons disagree, late afternoon meetings failing to deliver a concrete compromise. A dramatic siege in Adelaide, a thief and his hostage shot by police. Still in South Australia, a 23-year-old man killed in a frenzied shark attack. Australian troops in deadly combat in Afghanistan and tornado terror in the US. 400-kilometre-an-hour winds tear through towns near Washington. 10 News.
Coming up in sports tonight, Brownlow medalist Jason Ackermanis suspended for one match after being found guilty of kneeing. He'll now be ineligible for this year's Brownlow medal. Pakistan speedster Shoaib Akhtar may not have been the first to bowl over 161 k's per hour. Brett Lee recorded 161.8 against the Windies in 2000. The Aussie happy to allow Akhtar the honour.
You know, I'm just really excited for him, like really proud of him.
Sports tonight.
A man waits on death row.
He died in 28 days.
But the truth is still at large.
Sam did not plant that bomb. He did not kill those kids.
I am the only person on this earth who gives a damn whether you live or die.
Chris O'Donnell, Gene Hackman, The Chamber, 8:30 Saturday.
Now,
you
can
double
your
saving
power.
Call us now.
13 15 20. Comsec. Make it happen.
All the water in the world won't replenish your body with the minerals it loses during exercise. Rehydrating and replenishing with a splash of lemon flavour. New Powerade Sports Water. It's wetter than water.
If you call me right now on 948-1111, you can have an Italian fiesta and a New Orleans chicken pizza on our new Perfecto base and timeout ice creams for only $19.95 plus delivery fee. So pick up the phone and call me now.
When terrorists killed his family, it wasn't personal. But his vengeance will be.
It's over!
Collateral damage.
Now,
for
every
dollar
you
say,
Comsec
could
lend
you
one.
Call
13 15 20. Comsec. Make it happen.
Listen.
And amplifying when we come in with the swing. Just following the pattern, naturally harmonizing. Live from outer ghetto, we maximize it. Sound of the groove, I'm mother, we super styling.
Kahlua, drink the rhythm.
Comsec.
Regular.
Gearing.
Fancy.
Name.
Simple.
Idea.
Call.
Now.
13, 15, 20. Comsec. Make it happen.
Aunt Liz and Cousin Jeremy have blown into town with a couple of secrets and lies. The felons are about to prove you should never mix business with family. The Guardian, 8:30 Wednesday.
Rove Live, Shakira, Guy Pearce, Katrina from Big Brother still to come. In fact, with Katrina on the show, we thought it's a perfect opportunity.
Perfect opportunity to have
another Big Brother quiz. So that's what we're going to do. Let's get straight into it. Here we see Aaron in the diary room. Now, what did Big Brother tell Aaron here? A, to stop talking about nominations. B, to stop forming alliances. Or C, to stop impersonating Gilligan.
Because he's wearing a hat.
Here is Marty and Jess Flirt. What is Marty thinking about his girlfriend? A, absence makes the heart grow fonder. B, I can't wait to see her. Or C, what was her name again? he's getting in trouble when he gets out. Yeah, I don't know about that. She'll be making sound effects at him. In this one here, if Nathan wants to box, should he A, take his sunglasses off, B, work on his hook, or C, turn around and punch Shannon? Here in this one, as Aaron investigates the water heater, is Aaron A, checking out the new water heaters, B, reading the instructions, or C, wondering where the condoms come out? And finally, this last one here, it's, you may have seen it on the Uncut, the three-way all-girl pash. Oh, there's no joke, I just wanted to see it again. All right, let's meet our comedic guest for this evening, shall we? It's his first, It's his first time on Rove Live. He's just finished a successful stint at the Melbourne International Comedy Festival. Welcome him now, Dave Williams. Thank you very much. If I can just get this off my chest right at the moment here. I've actually, I don't know if you can see that, I've got remnant of a hickey. A hickey right there. Who gives hickeys anymore? Like when it happened, you know, everyone knows the sensation of when it happens. And when it, like, I felt the suction on my neck and straight away I was just like, did you just give me a hickey? She's like, oh yeah, I'm sorry, it's an accident that happens all the time. I'm so sorry, because I date classy women. And you know, I was like, you know, well, it was like, how can you accidentally give someone a hickey? You know, it's not like, I hope that's not an involuntary action for her. You know, she's sitting on a bus one time, someone drops their paper and she's like, oh, it's all right, I got it. I'm so sorry, it was an accident. Now, look, just to change the subject completely here, next time it rains, do yourself a favour and get outside and check out snails. Because the way I figure it is that snails have a very limited window of opportunity just to fully party on, and it's only when it's pouring down with rain, and they love it. You can tell they love it because their eyes are like out here like that. Blink, blink. That was a snail blinking. And, you know, but they can't get enough of it. They're so amped, they're so hyped about it, but they're so slow, you know. They're out there, it's pouring down with rain, they're out there, they're just going like, woo! Yeah! Oi, Jono, I'll meet you over by the rotting log. I'll race ya. Now, look, if there are any gum chewers watching, can you please do me a favour and not spit your gum out on the pavement or the sidewalk? Because I'm always the guy that will come along and step on that hot, manky piece of gum. And then with my next step, I'll step on a chip wrapper. And the chip wrapper sticks to the bottom of your foot, and you try to get it off with your other foot, which you just stepped in the same piece of gum, and it sticks to that foot. And as a result, you have to stand in the middle of the street doing this weird chip wrapper polka. I reckon that's how line dancing started. I do. I reckon this one dude just, you know, walked into a country and western club one time, stepped on a piece of gum, picked up a chip wrapper, achy breaky heart, just happened to be playing. Before you know it, he's like, don't break my heart. Achy breaky heart. Just don't. Everyone else is kind of standing around going, I think we can do that. Now, I don't know how many times you've seen this classic nature documentary scene where there's a cheetah in the grass stalking a whole bunch of gazelles in the distance, and gazelles, very beautiful animals, but... You know how they've got that sort of dumb hooved animal look about them where they're always sort of like... And then the chase starts happening. You know the chase starts happening because they start playing that gunga gunga chase music, right? And the cheetah just goes pew! All the gazelles, they're just standing around going. Nom, 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 you know that little leafy thing that they do? And you, what is that? And even the cheetah just goes, what is that? I'm going to have to eat you now. Thanks very much, people.
Lovely stuff. We'll be back with Shakira, Katrina from Big Brother, and Guy Pearce. We'll be right back.
The housemates have got the horn, and this time they're not holding back. This side of heaven, good things always come in threes. Big Brother Uncut, 9:30 Thursday.
Chartbusters, top-selling albums at an incredible price. Vince Andrea Bocelli, Diana Krall, and Mary J. Blige. Check out Chartbusters now. A massive range for small change.
Women who know how to protect themselves. Carefree, simply no better protection.
Oh, really spicy foods, chips and sauce, one too many coffees.
Oh, it's a bit like a cramp, a bit like a stitch.
It's the stress that brings it on.
Like being tied in knots. Skipping meals, always on the run.
It's a pain in the guts.
Buscopan, it's what I use for stomach aches.
It relieves the pain so fast.
Works in under 30 minutes. That's way fast. I love Buscopan.
What do you take for stomach ache?
Buscopan. Always read the label.
And use Buscopan only as directed.
Just want to do my time and get on with my life.
Danny Mills, inside for 3 years.
If you don't play ball, you could be with us for some time.
But he's only got 90 minutes to prove himself.
We're playing the cards.
And I'm with you.
Lose and they'll never let you forget it.
From the producer of Lock, Stock and Two Smoking Barrels and Snatch.
Not dangerous, are you, Mr. Footballer?
Only if you've got the boldness.
Vinnie Jones, Mean Machine.
In cinemas, May 9.
Don't give me colour that falls flat. Give me Feria by L'Oreal. The multifaceted hair colour.
It shimmers.
From every angle. Two times the highlights. Vibrant, shimmering colour I can see. Give me Feria by L'Oreal Paris. Because we're worth it.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on a Jupiter and Mars.
Get a powerful desktop PC without the desk. The Intel Pentium 4 Processor M. Designed for notebooks.
Escape.
I can be your hero, baby.
The number one album for Mother's Day. Show your mum she's number one with Enrique.
Oscar winner Gwyneth Paltrow, tall and elegant.
But have you seen her lately?
She's frantic, because if she catches the train, she could meet Mr. Right.
But if she doesn't...
Uh-oh.
The romantic hit Sliding Doors, 8:30 Friday.
Welcome back to Rove Live. Little something you want to mention for next week. We've got extreme death-defying escape artist Robert Gallup on the show. He came to us. He's got this nutty little idea that we're excited as it piqued our interest. Basically, he's going to be hanging himself by the feet from the Art Centre spire in Melbourne, which is about 100 metres high, and then he's going to set the rope on fire, and he's got I don't know how long to undo himself before he falls to his death. Sounded like riveting television, so it's going to be happening next week. I'm actually going to send Pete out there should anything happen. So something to tune in for next week. If that wasn't exciting enough, right now it's been missing in action, but it's back again. Let's find out who's in the swivel chair. And to find out who's in the swivel chair, let's ask Bruce Mansfield. Bruce!
Thanks, Rove. Tonight in the swivel chair, it's Bruce Samazan. Winner of the Silver Logie for Most Popular Actor in 1992, Bruce Samazan has starred in such hit soap operas as E Street, Home and Away and Neighbours. Bitten by a radioactive spider, Bruce developed strange powers and became a costume superhero. Last year, Bruce completed his postgraduate studies and is now a certified Doctor of Love. Ladies and gentlemen, Bruce Samazan.
Thank you, Bruce. And thank you, Bruce. We Bruce squared. There you go. All right, let's meet our next guest, shall we? He is one of Australia's hottest stars, making it big overseas with movies such as Priscilla, Queen of the Desert, L.A. Confidential and Memento under his belt. His new movie, The Count of Monte Cristo, opens Thursday. Here he is now, Guy Pearce.
So much easier in the swivel chair.
See, he got it easy.
I know. I want the swivel chair. Look at all those M&Ms.
They're smart. I have a Smarties. They're little ones. Do you want a crack in the swivel chair?
Well, maybe next time.
Have a seat.
I was going to bring a packet of M&Ms on. There's all these rumours about me not eating, so I'm quite happy to eat on public television.
You know, what's going on? What's going on?
I don't know. Someone decided when they watched Time Machine.
Mm.
But I was looking a little gaunt, apparently.
Gaunt? Isn't that a strange word?
Gaunt. It's a great word, though, I think. But I don't know if I'm gaunt. Gaunt to the point of distraction, apparently. And all these journalists, when I was in LA doing the publicity, said, how do you feel about being gaunt to the point of distraction? And I was there chewing on a Mars bar going, what do you mean? I don't know what you're talking about. So I'm happy to eat on public television.
Because the thing is, you're a naturally thin guy anyway. Mm. It was just because you did bodybuilding for so many years that I think people were under the impression you were huge.
Well, I don't know if... Yeah, maybe. I mean, during the Neighbours years and sort of early 20s, I was kind of a lot bigger than I am now, you know. So you lose a bit of weight and suddenly you've got an eating disorder, you know. Suddenly everything's going down the toilet, you know. No, everything's fine.
Oh, that's good. I'm glad to know. Now, the new movie is The Count of Monte Cristo. Mm-hmm. But are you trying to break some kind of record or something? Because you've got The Time Machine is out, then Count of Monte Cristo out this week, then Hard Word is coming out soon as well.
Yes.
Are you trying to make as many movies as you can in one year?
Well, I kind of figure it's better than actually...
Now, why do you look so ill? You're making so many movies.
I know, I'm so busy. It's ridiculous. But I figure it's better than trying to put together a retrospective.